It is now time to explain to people just what's wrong with me.
Yay!
What and how can I make this episode? This is me trying to figure out how to make an episode at the last second minute. I don't even feel like doing it, to tell you the truth. I'd rather be doing something else, but... Fuck.
No.
Nope.
Nice.
FBI, open up!
Execute Order 66.
I'll take fries with that. Waka 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 wah! So you want to hear my... beatbox? Boom, chitta boom, boom, chitta boom, chitta boom, boom.
Fuck her right in the pussy.
Come up.
No.
Yeah, what's up, guys? It's fucking the Jimmy James Show. What's going on? Right now, I'm standing up because I'm about to shit myself. This is a way to start a podcast. Honestly, I'm trying to figure out, like, how the fuck do I... Oh, wait, this might work. Can I plug a wire in? Guys, at this point in the show, you'd be like... This is him. I'm trying to figure out... Oh, fuck that. You know what? I don't want music. I was trying to figure out how to get these wires so I could do these noises. Now, I know how to do them. You know, like, put noises in, funny noises. You fucking monkeys laugh. I mean, people laugh. God, I really gotta get a hold of myself. Anyway, I'm shutting that the fuck off. So, it's Saturday, I wanted to sit down and play my fucking game. Seriously. I just wanted to sit down and play my game. Oop, can't really go anywhere with that plugged in now, can I? So you're gonna take a walk with me. But with better quality. First let me just, sorry. You know, I'm over here, I'm trying to get my baking skills on. I got a thought in my head, I just don't want it to leave. This is just me, I'm chopping up the powder. You gotta have this cake just right. Anybody interested in making a cake, you wanna have about, whatever's there, and you take about half of it and split it down the middle. Then what you do is, you roll that fucker up nice and tight, which is, I don't know the name of this. A lot of people have it. No. Yeah, I mean, no, nobody really, not a lot of people. Then what you do is you gotta really look at it really good. Take a good look at this line of dough. Make sure you're like, I'm gonna commit to this. And what you wanna do is breathe in. But when you breathe in, you wanna turn your head right or left. Breathe out, right? Cause the last thing you wanna do is blow that dough all over the place. And then you gently close one nostril with your finger, right or left. You put the, we'll just call this device, in your other nostril. And then you just go, yeah. And you always say something like, fuck yeah. And then you lick, and you know, get it all out of your nose. You want to unroll the device, make sure you got all of it. Put that somewhere in view, but not really giving a fuck at this point because you just done something, you know, fabulous. You made a cake, and, yeah. For some reason, what was I doing? I was, yeah, that's what I was doing. Jesus Christ. No, all bullshit aside, I was on the computer and I was on Anchor. And I'm like going down the analytics. Yeah, because I said it with me and Dwayne. I'm like, what the fuck does people listen to me for? What do they really get out of whatever's me? Fuck, I'm sitting down now. Now I'm committed. God damn it. Just trying to go to the bathroom. Now I'm committed to talking to you, motherfucker. Anyway, so I was like, why is people listening to me? So I was looking at the analytics. I wanted to see what people actually, like, percentage, what are they listening to, why are they listening to it, and, you know, I know I talk about a lot of shit out there, like mental health and stuff that's semi-important to a degree. So, I mean, I do a lot of funny shits, skits, and bits, like, I do a lot of weird shit. Sometimes I go back, I'm gonna be honest with you, and I'll listen to my podcast. Sometimes I have to. And then it's like, cause I want to hear what all these people are hearing, and I just fucking start laughing. Or it's not even something that's funny, just something I left out, and I'm like, oh my god, I can't believe I just said that. don't forget to, you know, also when you're baking the cake, you know, you want to breathe in a little bit, make sure you get a drink, and what you don't want to do is blow your nose. I don't know why that has anything to do with baking a cake. Guys, I was talking about snorting like coke or whatever the fuck you snort. That was not what I was doing. I promise you that. No, I mean I was, but it wasn't that. It wasn't coke. Anyway, I gotta write notes down here. I'm gonna forget. So what I was getting at to was my analytics. I was gonna be like, you know what? Fuck a podcast. I ain't doing it today. And then I look down and I'm like, dude, I have this many listens, plays. It wasn't many, because it was just Dissuade Me, Movies, BS, and Editing. And I'm like, damn, dude, that has more plays than This Is a Bonus, You're Welcome. You know, and it is stupid titles or whatever. But I'm like, now I feel committed. Now it's like, there's at least 15 people out there listening to this shit. I'm assuming I have a audience of at least 15. No, I have, like, I just looked at the analytics on Anchor. Like I said, this is Anchor is different. Spotify, all the same shit. By the way, thank you, Anchor. I'm sure I'll put that in there if I haven't already. And, I'm just saying thank you to the people that listen. How many X amount of many that is. If I have 18, I'm almost up to 1,800 views. Still didn't WD-40 my chair, by the way. We're going to get on to that. I have not checked any of my emails. I'm a fucker. I feel like I got my foot halfway in this podcasting thing, and then I got my other foot way over there somewhere. By the way, everything that I'm saying is coming to you live, like, in the moment. Honestly, I was like, I don't know, you know, those who know me, I'm like, I need a title for this episode that is me. I do have some in the making, which I'll share with you. I have, I can't because I closed my laptop, but I have my memoir. It was memoir, you know, my memoir, 1982, like, unknown. And it's literally going to be my life story, and I'm not going to be able to do it in one sitting. So I figured I'd do it in like a 3-part thing. That's going to be like the start of next year, the subscriber thing I was getting into. And I was going to be, You know, if somebody's gonna pay $1.99 a month, or even if it's a one-time thing, or listener support, subscription, whatever, they should get that extra. You know, it's like, alright, I'm not a celebrity. You know, I'm like, I don't have fucking my name on a star so people could walk on it all day. I always thought about that. You get your name on a star. It's just like, is that really an achievement? Because usually, like, when they show video of that, it's like, doesn't seem like it's, people are walking all over. I don't even know if this is a joke or anything. Like, you know, I'm just really just thinking off the top of my head. Like, people are walking all over you all day. And then you got a bum, like, just shitting. I'll take a shit on, I don't know. Who do I take a shit on today? George Clooney? I don't know. I really didn't have anything for this. For this episode, which is me. So what are you guys up to? What are yous doing? See, I would like to get into other stuff. I would like to get in sports and this and that. But everybody does that. Like, you could go literally throw a fucking stone in the air, and I'm sure it will hit somebody, and they'll be like, hey, I talk about sports. I talk about the Lord of the Rings and the after episodes of the after episodes and so on and so forth and blah, fucking blah. And I'm not saying I'm better than them, but I'm better than them. No, you're better than them. You're better than them. That's my Philly jersey. I'm talking so fast. You're better than them. I've done podcasts on days I didn't want to do a podcast. Like, for instance, today, right now, this second, at this moment, at this point in time, we are here. This is it. There is no other time but now. I did not want to do a podcast right this moment, but I did. Why am I still doing it? I don't know. What do I have to gain out of it? I don't know. I feels like I need a therapeutic session. So this is where I come to vent, say shit that probably doesn't make sense to a point. There's something on the way. I love saying that. That's one of my favorite lines. I gotta bring some new shit to the people that's been listening. I'm gonna dedicate this show to you. Whatever the fuck it is. Alright. Let's get down to some crazy shit. While my computer is off, I have my Xbox open, which is like a computer, but it's games involved. See, here's a lot of shit that I'll say off podcasting. Like, I'll, you ever watch a TV show and just be like, why is that such and such and such? Like, I actually made a point of that, like, within the Star Troopers, you know, stupid shit. I know that's stupid, it's made up, you know, Star Troopers, they have bad lines in movies and stuff like that, but I honestly want to know what's the big deal about podcasting. Why do people make a big deal out of it? And then all the people that do podcasting, I'm not gonna say all, I'm gonna say more than 80% of them, they do one or two episodes and they're done. That's it. And then all the people who actually do them on a consistent basis, I'm talking about, they're mostly celebrities. By the way, like, I'm giving you an example. I follow very little podcast, okay? Actually, I am unfollowing her. So I'm going to break it down. I don't even listen to him. Unfollowing that. I don't know what that is. January, unfollowing that. So here's what I'm talking about. People, they have not made any podcast in a while. Unfollowing that. All right, so I haven't heard him yet, so I'm going to unfollow that. So that was pretty much that. I haven't heard them yet. I'm going to unfollow that. I hate following shit. So that leaves me down to one podcast that I follow. No, I follow Suede B Podcasting only because, you know, I talked him into it. I'm like, dude, follow do podcasting. You should do podcasting. You should do podcasting. You should do your own podcasting. Listen, if I expire, I'm trying to read and talk at the same time. It's just words not coming out. Hold on for a second. I can always edit this shit out. I don't know what I'm looking for. I say that and then I don't do it, but I do it. So what I'll do is I'll be quiet so I know to edit. I wish there was an ad flag on Dobie. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Oh, the other day, I was looking up, getting all over the fucking place. I can't do it on Dobie. This is the shit I was trying to do. I was looking up, like, piano shit. I wanted to know, he's a pirate. For some reason, he's a pirate. Who plays that? Patrick, long name I can't say, but he's a pirate from the Pirates of Caribbean, not on crack. All right, by Patrick. Wow, that's a weird name. Okay, the way it's spelled is P-A-T-R-I-K. Okay, now my middle name is Patrick. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you're talking to Patrick. Spotlight Patrick. I don't know. I was thinking about doing another episode. So anyway, Patrick. Pitch Shama. Why does all these piano guys have to have these fucking complicated names? Can't you just be like, this is Mr. John Smith playing Pirates of the Caribbean. Go ahead, John Smith. It has to be, hello, this is Sidney Wartnot Makahall, or some Japanese guy that we pretend we can say his name correctly. Mr. Mushu. How do you spell that? That's M-U-S-H-U. Getting off subject, so I'm going to stop Dobie now. I don't feel like fucking uploading, fuckloading, and retarding. Plus, I'm going to probably add in the ad, so listen to the ad. Thank you. Thank you, Spotify. Thank you, Anchor. Thank you all the people behind this who make my life more miserable, because now I got to worry about what I'm putting out. Thank you. Thank you. Be right back. Guys, right now I am struggling. It's been two hours. I'm supposed to get things out. Saturday night is supposed to be my night where I'm just like, don't have to worry about topics, could be goofy. Fuck me in a bag of dildos. Don't lose your way.
Baba Booey. Baba Booey. Baba Booey.
Oh boy, guys, I'm trying. I really am. I don't know what else to do. I don't know. I'm like thinking, should I write them something funny in a rhyme? I don't know. Yeah, I'm really just running out of shit to talk about, guys. Might have to call it.
Run. Deja vu.
So you've seen your parents having sex, and then they turn around and ask.
They ask swamp!
I thought I had some other ones. I was looking for the I don't know. What the hell am I doing?
What the dog doing?
I guess not funny. Let her go, yeah, just let that bitch go.
Doja.
No, no, don't. No, no, don't touch me there. This is my Nuno Square. No, no, don't touch me there.
Shut the fuck up.
Alright guys, I'm done. I'm out of steam here, out of options, out of time. As I'm not, you know, I'm like slowed down a little bit more than I usually am. It's because I don't want to do any of this. You know, I didn't want to talk, I didn't want to do anything, and now that I talked for a little bit, I felt better. Just giving you how I'm feeling second by second, minute by minute. Dolby Digital, Dolby on. All right, guys, I'm gonna be real with you tonight. It was like 2-3 hours later. And I was sitting there, kind of scrambling, like, what do I want to make this podcast about? Seriously, I'm gonna chill out a little bit and talk to you on a deeper emotional level, not the one where you're spiraling out of control and you guys probably think I'm on crack or some kind of drug that has some sort of speed into it, but the truth is, it's all an illusion, it's a lie. I'm actually having a terrible night. I just realized that sitting here trying to do a podcast, I'm like, am I that bad where I can't even come up with some sort of topic where I'm all over the fucking place? I mean, if I had to make like a fucking real blooper reel, not a funny one, like a fucking mess up reel, I would have a lot of audio. A lot of the times I'll cut it back or delete it. Sometimes I keep it in. And then I started to think, like, you know what? It wouldn't be right not to put something out because somebody could be having a bad day out there. So, to that, Mr. Smith, Mr. A, Mr. B, Mrs. A, Mrs. C, whatever the hell you want to call yourself, a listener that wants to listen to me. I know I usually do some goofy shit on the weekends, and I make something funny up. I might do that still. The night is still semi-young. I wanted to get this out by, or before 12. It's 20 minutes till it's 11:40, and I'm sitting here just thinking, like, I got nothing. And then I was like, there's my fucking title. I got nothing. Or I have nothing, but I got nothing. Just to sound more fucked up. Pseudonyms. Synonym. Words are weird, aren't they? Like, just off the top of my head, since we're getting into words and you guys decided, hey, let's talk about that. Who makes up these things? Like, is there a word guy somewhere in the world, like, sitting there and be like, you know what? Hey, you know what? That could be... Hey, this... Everything... Wait. The things... They're coming out of my mouth. Like, for instance, like, who made the word... I don't know. Pizza. It was Italians, right? But, I don't know. I'm half Italian. I mean, did they just look at this thing and think, oh, it's a pizza. It's a pizza? Oh, did you want to, I think it was somebody, this is like off the top of my head. I didn't study this or nothing. Like, did you want a piece of this? And the guy probably said, pizza? You know, or maybe he was like from a different land. And they called it a different thing. Maybe it was called, like, round dough. Round food. And then, you know, he's like, oh, can I have a piece of this? And then they say, a piece? Pizza? Piece of this? Pizza? And then it came pizza. There you go. I just figured out how pizza became pizza. You're welcome. What other tricks do I have? And for my last trick of the evening, no, I don't fucking know. Do you see what kind of depressed state I'm in? And I was gonna put this thing in. It wasn't a bit. It was like a on the news. I don't. Maybe I did, but I was on the YouTube, and I don't go on the news part of the YouTube in Philadelphia, PA. But in Philadelphia, the homicide rate is going up. Like, I don't want my news guys to be saying that. Like, yo, keep that shit down. Like, all right, Philly's bad, but, like, I don't need the news people look so depressed. Like, they're out there report, like, this guy was trying to make a delivery, and somebody was trying to rob him. He went to fight back, and he was shot and killed. And that is a real story. And I'm not making any light of that. But that is like every night in Philly. It's so bad. It's like, what, one day I might, this is why I don't watch the news. I would literally probably like start testing out the weight of my ceiling fan and just be like, it'll hold me. It'll definitely hold me. It's getting bad. This is why I dive into this shit and go into the universe, which I already have done, by the way. The universe and black holes, which is dropping Monday. I think I have it set for like 12:01 a.m. Monday. Fuck anxiety. So, like, I'm sitting here going, like, what am I gonna do? I don't feel creative. I don't feel like writing anything down. I don't feel funny. I don't feel this. I have no bits material. And then I'm like, you know what? Podcasting isn't about that. That's not what I did podcasting for. You know, it was 15 minutes I did Dobie, you know, through Dobie. I always say Dobie, but I did 15 minutes of that. And I'm like, what the fuck was I talking about? That's the thing. The most honest thing I said in that 15 minutes was, I feel committed. It felt like I had a responsibility to do this. And I already have enough pressure on myself. I mean, I don't need any added pressure for what? Anchor ads? Spotify? Jesus Christ. Hey, guy who works at Spotify who hires people. You hear me, right? I do all this shit myself. Hire me. So I can put some better fucking material so I can get you better listeners, more viewers. That's more subscriptions, more money, more downloads, more uploads, more fuck yous, more fuck loads. More fuck loads of uploads. We could talk about anything and everything. And the guy would be like, well, you're already kind of on Spotify. And I'm like, all right, well, still, put me on your payroll. I have nothing but time. And basically, I have a mind that could be abused. So basically, if I, you know, I treat my mind like a hooker. It's open for business. So come get some of this. Dive in to the middle of my brain and see what's there. See if I'm insane. Ring the doorbell. Let's see what pops out and gets you. I'm not running longer here than 10 minutes, so if you're having a bad day, I'm speaking to that one person out there who actually might be listening. Stop your whining. No. Cheer up, it'll be alright. I know it sucks. I know. Trust me, I know. I'm literally going through it now, and I'm doing this shit. And then I'm not done. I gotta fucking upload, put things in the spots, and edit, and fucking blah blah blah. That is how fucking lazy but upsetting I am that I have to do that. It's the easiest thing to do. But at the same time, like, Swaybe podcast, like Dwayne, whatever, fucking Swade Dwayne, you guys know who I'm talking about, like, he's scared shitless to do this, to do what I'm doing. I'm like, dude, I do it all the time, but I'm not scared. It's like a sense of, like, commitment that, what happens, like, when people literally start listening. So I figured, fuck it, do it 3 times a week and I'll commit to that. At least if it's not for somebody out there, it's for me. I mean, I see, like I said, I see people do this all the time. They do these podcasts. The one girl I told you, me, you know, I'm not, this is no knock on her, but like me and ADHD or whatever. And she did a couple episodes and then she stopped. Like, did it go away? Did you solve it? Is that it? Can we get the answer? It's not just about ADHD. There's people out there who have way worse diseases. And, like, you don't really hear me get into that because I'm not a professional on that. But when it comes to mental health, yeah, I'm probably one of the world's leading experts on that shit. I'm stuck in a box 99% of the fucking day. And it's not a jail cell, but it feels like a jail cell. You know, gotta sit here and take care of fucking 2 older people who literally cannot take care of themselves. Every day, it's like, I'm gonna do this on, I planned on doing that on my subscription, so I don't wanna get too much away, but like, I was really gonna get to the funny, nitty gritty parts of life, because people think other people's lives are funny. As I'm over here looking, fucking bag of candy, gone. I think I gained like 20 pounds, but it's there, but it's not there. Fuck, I forgot to eat chips with my sandwich. I fucked that up. Yeah, so I would talk about, you know, like, you guys got to know the backstory before I get into the rest of what life is like. The one time I think I put it on one of my podcasts, I was yelling at my dad, like, who the fuck would waste a bullet on you? Like, we were talking about this before I did a podcast. If we were to put a camera in our house, we would be like a reality thing, you know, like what fucking most famous people do, because, well, we gotta know what they're doing. Fucking people are just weird. It's so crazy here, but it died down a little bit. That was a bad fucking thing to say, because somebody really just did die here. There's a lot of people that died in this house. Let's see, we got my uncle. Ow, I just hit myself with my fucking pen. All right, so we got my uncle passed away here. My dad's late girlfriend, shout out to her, Regina, passed away here. My niece, she didn't pass away here, but she lived here. My sister, she didn't pass away here, but she was living here. That's when I moved in, right after that-ish. I think it was between or it, this, yeah. No, actually, I was living here when she was still alive. She kind of, like, left. So, like, this is the shit I would get in, and then I would tell you, you know, like, she passed away. Like, all these people passing away, okay? I'll give you a rundown real quick. One, cancer. One, OD. One, old person. My grandmother passed away here. Shit, I forgot. She passed away in the house. Jesus Christ, there's a lot of spirits floating around this house. And, now, I did, see, like, I don't want to get into this, but I gotta make something happen. There is spirits, if you guys don't believe in that. There is spirits. It's a real thing. I talked about this before. If you don't believe me, you could do it yourself. Stop being lazy. And don't, your phone's not the best recording device for it. Okay? You ever hear that, I'm gonna forget the word. Pareidolia? Pareidolia, where you see a picture and it like looks like something else, like a cloud in the sky looks like some one thing and somebody sees another. That's, I don't know the name of it for whatever. I'll just make it up. Hearing different things. We'll call it, ring dings. So hearing ring dings is, pretty much, nah, I need more sciencey word for that. You want to use a digital recorder because the quality is better. It picks up on a higher frequency, way higher than the average human can pick it up or your phone. Your phone has the built-in capability, but it is not a digital recorder. No matter how many apps you get, it's still not going to be as good as my fucking 10-year-old Olympus recorder, which was like $60, and the only thing is I can only slow the speed down to 0.5. Jesus Christ, I'm explaining to you my spiritual side, but you could do that yourself. Anyway, until the people come and throw me into a gray room, or I die of a stroke, heart attack, or whatever, I guess I'll just keep doing this. I really don't know what else to do. I got 20,000 channels. Nothing's on. Don't feel like getting into video games. I figured, all right, if I'm going to be depressed, I'm going to take like one night a week just to chill and not give a fuck. But I just can't. I can't do it. I think it's getting older and just realizing, wow, I'm running out of information to learn. I could be funny about it. Like, there's a lot of people to go out there. And then, I mean, instead of killing people, you know, go out and make your neighbor laugh. And I don't mean like your actual neighbor. Nobody likes their neighbors. They tolerate them. My neighbors are all right. Everybody has recorders. It's fucking weird. Anyway, I think we're the only neighbors that don't have cameras, like, up. We're, like, still on that, like, yeah, we don't care. Couple things happened to me lately. I don't really want to get into it. I was going to save these stories for other times, but, I'll give you a quick story. Like I said, I was going to give you a quick story before. You know, somebody feeling down out there. I think I told that one story. I used to have anxiety attacks when I was a kid. You know, I didn't know what they were. Like, I didn't know they were anxiety attacks. You know, they weren't, wasn't labeled as that. I would walk into the classroom and I gotta be, Jesus Christ, I was what, 6? I would walk in and I would just start fucking freaking out. And I didn't understand why. Like, I felt like it was in my chest, like, where it's not your heart. It's hard to explain. It's like the nerves. It's still bothers me to this day. I just tolerate it to a higher level. And still yet then that bothers me. And I don't know why. Mostly it's in the head. You know, it's like in your head. A lot of the shit that bothers you is in your head. You can overcome it. And just because I'm saying it doesn't make it any easier, but if you really want it, all you have to do is let yourself really think about it get to that level of emotion where there is almost no emotion, if that makes any sense to you out there, and just let it go like a fucking weight. And this is why I do podcasting, you know, but it doesn't mean it's always going to be fucking peachy keen and, you know, dandy. It's going to be dandy. I didn't even really want to go on talking too much here, but I'm at the point where I need to do something because I'm not tired. I know I could go to bed in a little bit. About 5 more minutes, I'm going to end this, hopefully. But sorry, get back to the story. Sorry if I'm a little all over the place, too. I'm in the middle of taking my pills. More. I want more. So I would have that anxiety attack as a kid, and it wasn't like it was when I was older. Now, when I was younger, I would just want to get out of the classroom. I didn't want to be seen by anybody. So, this is not food I'm eating, so I'm not being rude. So I have a lot of anxiety and I deal with it, but when I was a kid, I didn't know, like, it was different as I got older. And then it disappeared for a while. Then it came back. I don't really remember having any anxiety from the age I got put away, juvenile detention. I don't remember having any anxiety. I think I was too on my, I was too on edge to have it. It's so hard to explain how that could sound like, well, wouldn't that give you anxiety? No, because when you're from the place I'm from, it felt more comfortable for things to be in chaos, because in chaos, I felt more at home. Because I'm like, this is how my brain is all the time. So if it's around me, I'm like, this is like my brain. Yeah. So, got put away. And this is going to be in my memoir story, but I'll do that later. So I got put away. Jump ahead of time. And I don't remember having any anxiety when I was 16 up until I think I met my first, you know, the one type of person. And yeah, then I started having it later on, not right away, but later on because of that. And the chaos wasn't there. It was the fact that I felt like I couldn't control anything. You guys don't know a lot about me, which you think you do. I say a lot, but I don't really give you guys a lot. When it comes to anxiety, emotional, and ADD and alphabet, I'll tell you, but well, you know, I kind of back off when it comes to more personal shit, which I'll get into because I'm going to have to. I'm going to have to take that step towards the edge of fucking madness. But for now, guys, you know, I'm sorry to cut it short, but yeah, it's, I want to get this out there. Sorry to be so crazy real, which is, you can email me at the Jimmy James Show. A to Z. I'm sorry, the Jimmy James Show at Gmail. There's no A to Z in the email. Any questions if I ever check it? Yeah. Hope you feel better if anybody's having a bad day. And if you weren't having a bad day, you probably are now. I'm like, well, fucking shit. I was coming over here thinking I was going to laugh. And I'm not in the mood today. All right, guys. Well, I'll listen to this, and then whatever I miss, I'll make up later on. I just gotta put this fucking thing down before I throw it through the wall. Seriously, that's how I feel. Alright, like always, take care of yourselves and one another. This is Jimmy James saying peace out.
Hey guys, I want to give a shout out to Facebook. I know this is off topic, but I want to say thank you to a very lovely, lovely young lady out there. I don't want to mess up her name, so I'm going to learn it first. Marissa Feria. She's from Portugal. or Portuguese. I'm just, I didn't know. I didn't know I could have that kind of effect on somebody like across the world who was like hitting me up, said happy birthday, and here I'm not going on social and I'm not even noticing this. I mean, I'm not saying that nobody said happy birthday. What I'm saying, this person is not around me. Don't know. And we just had a wonderful conversation. And I don't know how to speak Portuguese. And she doesn't know how to speak English. So it was a lot of translating. But she's been listening to my stuff for a while. And I did not know this. So to Marissa, I just want to say thank you, and before the week's end, I will hopefully learn Portuguese. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Much love to Marissa. I can't say your last name yet. So, that's it. Take care. And like always, take care of each other. And like always, sorry about that. And like always, take care of yourselves and each other.